Tina Cooks is made possible through the generous support of
G's Hot Dog Cafe, home of the Chicago Dog,
Papa John's Pizza,
Leominster, Fitchburg, Marlboro, Worcester,
KC's Body Connection Massage Center, connecting body, mind, and spirit, Boucher Construction, Central Mass Sand and Gravel. Okay, the water is on. This evening we're going to do antipasto and pasta carbonara. Stay tuned. Okay, the first thing we're going to start with is the antipasto. And I'm going to have help from my mother, Lena Campobasso. We're going to go over to the fridge and we're going to grab our stuff for our antipasto. Alright, here you go, Mama. I went and bought some wonderful cold cuts today. We got salami and prosciutto, provolone cheese. I have a cucumber, tomatoes. Take that, Ma, and go with that. My lettuce, that's good. It's a good thing I got you here. I would have forgot the lettuce.
The olives.
The olives we'll grab. Yeah. I'm going to use the big green olives too. I think we might have to open a jar of black olives. I don't seem to have ones open. So we'll start out with this. And then we'll cut over to the other stuff.
I'll take these over to the sink and wash.
Okay, you want to wash those? That'd be good. She's gonna go wash that. I'm gonna start by cutting up some lettuce. Okay. Now antipasto means it's something before your meal. It's a pre-meal thing. Some people don't use a lot of lettuce. I've seen antipastos that are just meat and cheese and tomatoes and roasted peppers and, you know, different kinds of tomatoes, sun-dried tomatoes. They make them with a lot of things. All right, so I'm just gonna cut up about, I'm gonna leave this little chunk of lettuce because what I have over there is I have some romaine too. I like romaine lettuce, I throw it in. You can use a Boston lettuce. You can use, they have so many different lettuces. You can use arugula. You can use, I'm not a bitter lettuce person. I don't really like arugula. I'm not an arugula user. So we're gonna get some of this romaine that I pre-washed because, oops, it's important that you pre-wash lettuce today. I don't know. There was a time where I didn't worry about it so much, but I think with everything today, you need to really wash your lettuce. You really need to wash it.
Okay, do you want me to wash
the cucumbers? Wash it, yeah, wash the cucumbers.
Do you want me to peel it?
No, that's a seedless, Ma. That should be nice and tender. That should be nice and tender. That's a seedless tomato. It's a European seedless. I'm just cutting strips like this. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to take it over and I'm going to mix it all in. I think that's good for lettuce. Yeah. I'm going to break up some of this because it's long. Okay. Now this is just based, this is a very, very simple antipasto. Okay. You can use all kinds of things in an antipasto besides your cold cuts. Like I said, roasted tomatoes, sometimes sun-dried tomatoes. You can use marinated mushrooms. You can use all kinds of stuff. This I'm gonna move out of the way. Over here. Now over here I have some. These are artichokes. Now I just got them out of a can. You can also buy them marinated, okay? I don't like the marinated ones. I think they're a little bit strong. So I just use the one out of the can. If you make fresh ones, that's great, but, and I don't use a lot, I just sprinkle them a little here and there. I love an antipasto before the meal. I think it's great. When we were younger, we always saved our salads and stuff for the end of the meal. And, but I like the antipasto before the meal too. So however you're used to doing it, it's good. That's all the artichokes I'm going to put in there. Okay. This is a nice little salami. It's a Genoa salami. It's a little bit small, but let's see. We're going to have to taste it. Oh, it's good. It's got a nice smoky flavor. Very good. And this is prosciutto. What are you doing, Mark? Cutting eggs?
Yeah.
She's going to cut eggs. We're going to have eggs in there. Okay, now I'm going to move this over a little bit.
I figured I'll let you place the cucumber.
Because what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the salami and I'm going to roll it. And a nice little thin cigars. You just put it in there like that. You want me to put the cucumbers
in
too?
Yeah, put the cucumbers in. I'll just cut everything for
you. You're going to just cut everything for me? Okay. Wow, those cucumbers are great. Okay. Quarter of them. Yeah, stick them in there for me. Otherwise, I'll be making this all day. You don't help me. Cucumbers are good. These are the seedless cucumbers. They're the European seedless. They're really, really nice and sweet. Sometimes you get the cucumbers and they're bitter. And I don't like them bitter. And these are nice, the skin is nice and tender and they're nice and sweet. She's putting the eggs around. I'm gonna do the rest of the salami. You can use cabagola, you can use soppressata, you can use a mortadella, whatever meat you like. I'm partial to the prosciutto and the salami, and I love the provolone cheese. So, but you can, I love soppressata too. When we went to Italy, we had some soppressata. When you go to Italy, they have cold cuts and bread for breakfast. I was like so impressed with that. They don't have eggs and bacon. No, they have cold cuts and cheese and bread and fruit. It was wonderful. I loved it. That's okay, that happened. That's okay.
Okay.
All right, so next we're going to do the tomatoes, Mom.
How do you want them cut?
Just like pieces like this. I like to keep everything uniform, so however you start, that's how you finish. Ma, do you usually twirl the prosciutto too? You
yeah,
wind it?
I would.
Okay.
Definitely.
I'm gonna put one piece in the middle, like that. Pretty, pretty. Okay, now the prosciutto, I had them sliced nice and thin, okay? And I think what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna actually cut it in half because that's a big piece of prosciutto to stick in your mouth. I'm gonna wind it so that it comes out long, like this. All right. And then we're gonna cut it in half so that it looks like the salami.
That's good.
And we're gonna put that in the next row. Oh, it's kind of unwound, so we'll wind it again. Okay. Thanks. Going to town, Ma.
Can you get the, where's the provolone?
The provolone's right here. You wanna slice that for me?
You want to roll it?
I don't know. What do you think? You want to roll it or slice it?
Well, seeing that you're rolling everything, I would roll it.
Roll it? Okay,
yeah.
We'll roll it. We'll roll it. That sounds good to me. I can't wait to eat this.
What are you going to put for a dressing?
I usually use an Italian dressing. Like, I buy the Good Seasons.
Good Seasons.
Yeah, and I mix it, you know, fresh. Because the reason why I like to use that, and I'll be honest with you, is I have this strawberry balsamic vinegar. Oh, it makes the most wonderful salad dressing. And you can use lemon, or you can use cider vinegar, or you can use wine vinegar. So you can use whatever you want, you know, for a dressing. You know, but it mixes up fresh. It's great. You use your olive oil and your vinegar, and it's just, I like it much better than the other bottles and stuff. Although I do like a wishbone.
put
the tomatoes on. I can't. I'm doing
wrong
with you.
No, you're better at decorating. Oh. I'll let you decorate.
She's going to drive me crazy. That's what happens when mother and daughters work together. When me and my mother do anything in a kitchen, she has cooking experience, and I have cooking experience. And the big battle is who has the most experience. But I told her, she only worked in a school cafeteria. I was an actual chef, which gives me a little more experience than her, which she'll argue that point forever. So,
anybody who can make school food tasteful is...
That's right, you are, you're right, Mom. You do win an award for that. Although I gotta tell you, some of the school meals I had were not tasteful. Not to be a jerk, but hey. But you, I didn't have you in my school anyway, so. But. All right, you think that's enough prosciutto, Mom?
Yeah, you got so much on here that it's really good though.
Okay, now put the meat, the cheese rolls on there. And, all right, then we just got olives. I'm gonna let you start with the green olives, and I am going to get out the black olives while you do the green olives. See, it's good to have my mother helping me because I forgot the black olives, and instead of taking a break, I can just go open the can of olives. I'll be right back. And you can watch her. I want put a little more cheese on there. I love cheese.
This really looks good, Christina.
Yeah, I think so.
That's gonna make a really good salad.
Yup. Now, usually I like eggplant on this too, and I have eggplant in the freezer, but. It's in the freezer. I usually take it and toast it up. I might run down and get some.
Mamma, solo per te la mia canzone vola. Mamma, sarai con me tu non sarai più sola.
Gina, I don't think there's too much room to put anything else on this.
That's okay. Well, I'm going to cut, do a little bit of eggplant. Now, I went down cellar. In my freezer downstairs, I always have peppers. I always have eggplant. I always have this just stuff that I feel I need so that when I do stuff like this, I can put this in the toaster oven, and in a few minutes, it's going to be nice and crispy again. Oh, you know what we're missing, Mom? Tuna.
Tuna.
You can't forget the tuna. Of course I did, but hey. This is how most holidays go. Where is my tuna?
It's great to have Italian tuna. That's the best one.
With the olive oil.
Yeah, with the olive oil.
Yeah, here we go. Now you use a fork and you twist it.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
No, go ahead.
No, go ahead, you do it. I want you to show me how to do it.
Oh, Christina.
Ma, I want you to help me do this. You're doing a great job. Look at how wonderful this is. This is going to be great.
I'll tell you, Christina, this is a meal in itself. I love this.
Yeah. You know what else I like, too, is I like a purple onion.
Oh, yeah.
But a nice sweet purple onion, but somebody that uses the camera.
I don't think I ever used a purple onion.
No, I don't think we did when we were kids.
Antipasto.
No. But most of the restaurants I've worked in, they use.
They don't need that.
You don't want to use the whole can?
No.
Okay. I would throw on the whole can. But that's me. This is the antipasto. This is the meal before the meal. That's what I call it. The meal before the meal. All right, we're going to pick up. We're going to take a few minute break, and we'll be back. All right, the water's boiling. That's a good thing. I got my box of pasta ready, but the first thing I'm gonna do when I make my carbonara is I'm gonna start out with some pancetta, which is an Italian bacon.
You can also use prosciutto. I've seen prosciutto used with this. As a matter of fact, I've used it a few times. It's very good. But I am going to start out with the pancetta. I'm going to put on my pan on a medium heat, okay? And I am going to use a little bit of oil to render the pancetta, only because I like olive oil in here. So we'll start out with some olive oil in the pan. A lot of times I use cream in my carbonara, and tonight I'm going to use cream. But I have seen it made with chicken broth. So if you don't want cream, you could use chicken broth. So what I'm going to do now is I have the pancetta here. The pancetta is just, that's exactly what it is, it's bacon. Only it's not smoked like the regular bacon, okay? We're going to see what one piece gives us here. You want little chunks of the bacon, okay? It's got pepper on it, and you know it's a nice little flavor, nice little. You can get this just about now at any deli. They'll slice it for you. If you don't want big pieces, have them slice it thin. But I like it, you know, where I can have chunks of it. I think I'm going to do a couple of pieces, because I don't think this is going to quite be enough. Now what you want to do is you want this to render, because it's, you know, it's you need it to render. It's like a bacon. Now the reason why I'm working alone is the antipasto just fatigued my mother. So she went and sit down and relaxed before we have supper. I'm just going to finish cutting up this pancetta. I'm going to put this down just a little bit. Just kind of, I don't want it to move too quickly. And I got to get one of my pan, my wooden spoon, out of my wooden spoon collection. It's always nice to have a wooden spoon collection. I am now going to drop my pasta because this dish does not take a long time. It's not one of those dishes that you're going to be doing for an hour. It's 10, 15 minutes and you're done. A good after when you get out of work meal. Okay. We're going to drop some farfalle. I love farfalle. I'm going to let this pancetta go a little bit. Now while this is cooking, I am going to mince a little tiny bit of onions. But I want it very, very fine, very, very small. I don't want big pieces. And I don't want a lot. Okay. So I'm just going to take this. You gotta have some of the sweet onion in there. You just gotta. Alrighty. We're gonna get that going. Okay, I'm gonna let this saute a little bit because it really needs to cook up a little bit. Okay? When I put my pasta in the water, I always salt my water before it comes to a boil. I don't wait for it to come to a boil and then salt it. I always salt it before. And make sure if you have too many cooks in the kitchen that you make sure everybody knows there's salt in the water. You don't want everybody salted. Okay, now we're going to add our peas. Now these peas are, they're just frozen peas. There's nothing special about them. They're just frozen. If you want to use fresh, use fresh. I like frozen peas because they're nice and easy. You usually have them in your freezer. I do that. I buy frozen peas, frozen corn, because they're convenient. You have them, you know, in your freezer. You've always got them there. I'm putting a little bit of pepper. I'm going to add a little bit of granulated garlic, not too much. I don't want to kill everybody with garlic because I'm going to make like an Alfredo sauce. So you don't want it too garlicky. I'm going to throw in some parsley for flavor and color. Okay? And we're going to let this go. Now these peas do have to cook a little bit. So we're going to cover them up and we're going to let them cook just a few minutes. And And while that's cooking, I'm going to stir the pasta.
Oh, yeah. Good to go. Excellent.
Cover that up just a tish. And we're going to let this cook a little bit. Okay, so my peas are starting to get tender. My pasta is cooking. Now, if you look in here, this pancetta is chunks. I like it like that. I don't like it too thin. If you want it thinner, you can julienne it thinner, and it'll come out thinner. The onions have also disappeared. They've gotten nice and soft and translucent in here. Now, this is the difference between the two carbonaras. You can put chicken broth in here, like about a half a cup or so. Take your pasta, dump it in there, mix it with cheese, and that's what I call a white version, or a, you know, won't have the cream in it. But what I do is I take a cup of cream and an egg, because I like the egg for the thickening. You don't have to use the egg. I've made it without the egg, okay? And we're gonna mix in our egg real good. We're going to lower this down real low, and I just fried my arm. I'm going to lower that down. So when you do, this is almost like an Alfredo. So when you do an Alfredo sauce, you use one egg to one cup of cream. All right? Now we put that down quite a bit. All righty. I'm going to put that in there, and we're just going to mix it around like this, make sure our pancetta and everything's in there, and I'm going to take some Romano cheese. You can use Romano, or you can use the Parmigiano, whichever one you like to use. I think we were more Romano cheese users than Parmesan cheese users. Okay, I'm going to mix this in. I'm going to bring this up just so that it comes. You don't want this to simmer because it will curdle, okay? Okay. I'm just going to let that sit a minute. I'm going to make sure there's enough salt and pepper. I didn't go crazy on the salt. As a matter of fact, I didn't salt because I wasn't sure how salty the pancetta would be, which it's not. So I am going to add a tish of salt. Only because I didn't add any at all. I'm not going to add a lot. I'm just going to add a light, light sprinkle. Okay. Now we're going to check our pasta. I'm going to leave this on low because I don't want it to simmer. Okay. Now I'm going to check my pasta. Make sure you don't catch your towel on fire like I do all the time. All right, here we go. Now you want this al dente. It's still a little bit hard. I'm going to let it cook some more. All right, so I'm gonna leave this on nice and low, and we're gonna wait a few minutes for our pasta because it's just not ready yet, and I can't rush it, okay? So now our pasta is ready. I gotta make sure, because since I got gas burners, these sides of these pans get really hot, one side usually does. I'm gonna drain this out the best we can. You don't wanna, if there's a little bit of water, it's not gonna matter, but you don't want a ton of water, okay? Pasta and drop it in the carbonara sauce, and we're going to toss this around like so. Now if you had done this with just the chicken broth at this point, you would throw in your cheese. You wouldn't throw it in before this point, okay? But where this is a like a cheese sauce, an Alfredo sauce, I put the cheese in with the cream and the eggs, which is going to, that's the difference between the two sauces. And you're going to let this simmer out a little bit. Not too much, because you won't have it on too high, because your cream will curdle. All right, now see how beautiful, look at that. We got the pancetta in there and the peas in there. And it's a nice light cheese sauce. This is going to go spectacular with that antipasto me and Lena made. Lena, my mother. Okay, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to make sure that this eggplant gets another real small toast, and we'll top the antipasto with the eggplant. Okay, we're gonna bring this to the table, and we'll be all set. Okay, first we're gonna top off our antipasto with some eggplant. Now, all I did was put it in the toaster oven. Okay, so that it got a little bit warm, and I do like to do this at the last minute. Now this was not deep fried. This was broiled in the broiler in my oven. I love eggplant like that also. A little less calories. Okay. We're just gonna scatter these pieces. You don't have to have eggplant if you don't like eggplant. Like I said, antipasto, you can do however you wanna do it. Whatever you like to eat. Okay, so that's the eggplant on top of the antipasto. Now we're gonna get the pasta. Okay, I'm gonna bring this over. And we're gonna plate it up in here. Oh, the elbow still hurts a little bit. That's okay, I'm getting better. And there, oh, look at how beautiful that is. That is a great meal. Awesome, carbonara. Okay, so I'm gonna have Gina carry the antipasto. Lena, come in the shot. And this is the carbonara, okay? So Lena, Tina, and Gina are gonna be serving antipasto and carbonara. Thank you for watching Tina Cooks. Have a good night. Dying of course, it's hot in here. See Lena sitting? Lena's relaxing.
You're not taking my picture, are
you? Yeah, he is. I think we should throw it in there too. Come in. Hello, who's here, Gina? Yeah, the kids are arriving for supper. They just have. Everybody wonders who eats the food? The kids eat the food, and they know just when to come. Come on, we're not shooting. Matthew Wayne from class.